I got to ask, though, if you're a psychic, how come you didn't see the police coming and they were going to arrest you?
You know, Anderson, there's more than just being able to see the future in terms of the counseling that's provided. It's a very
I know,
fine
but you would think she has a vested interest in seeing her own future if she can really see it.
Evangelists and people in religious circles take donations and money to help them. And the only difference between psychics is a lot of times psychics promise to give the money back. But there's nothing wrong with taking money from people to counsel them and help them.
Well, no, there's
a
big difference between, I mean, if you're comparing her to a televangelist who does faith healing, I could see some sort of comparison. But if you're talking about people donating in a church, it's an entirely different thing. You're promising a service. You're promising that you have some power, that you have some insight, and that you're going to give real concrete information that's going to change and help somebody's life. But it's a fraud. In her case, she's admitting, Grace, you're admitting it's a fraud.
In some sort of a way, we obviously do in some sort of a way, must give some type of proper information to these people if they're actually paying us for what we're doing.
Well, that's not true at all, Grace.
You customers.
Well, of course there are, and there are a lot of desperate people out there looking for information. And if you say, if I could give you a reading and give you, you know, 10 pieces of information, and if you're desperate enough, you'll believe, you know, a couple of them will stick. You know, you have trouble in your relationship. There's a new person coming into your life. Your husband is cheating on you. If you throw enough stuff up, something's going to stick.
You know, psychics are like everybody. There are good ones and there are bad ones, Anderson. There are some that truly help people. I've represented people who have gotten in trouble before, and some of their clients actually come to court to try to help.
I agree. There may be good and
their lives have been helped.
I agree. There may be good and bad people involved in this, but the person you're sitting next to is facing 20 years in jail and has admitted fraud and swindling multiple people. Grace, I got to say, it sounds like you are a bad psychic if you're even a psychic.